The subject of my discourse is entitled, Do Married Men Make the Best Husbands? I feel that I'm in a position to converse intelligently on this subject because I happen to be a married man myself. I'm not bragging about it, understand, nor do I wish to say anything against marriage. I'm not a profane man as a rule, and furthermore, I'm really very, very happy. Why I'm married now? Well, it's almost 4 years, and I'm so happy that really it doesn't seem like more than 12. And I'll tell you why. It's because we get along so beautifully, my wife and I. Why, only 2 nights ago, we were sitting in the parlor, and I held her hands for 3 hours. If I'd have let go, she'd have killed me. It's a funny thing how I came to meet my wife. One of those seaside romances. I was introduced to her by a chap to whom I owed $3. He knew that I would never pay him back while I was conscious, so in order to get square with me, he introduced me to this female dreadnought, and we got to be very friendly. Every day we'd go in bathing together, and that is what really started this whole thing. Here is where the romance creeps in. One day, she got out a little too far. Of course, I don't want to pose as a hero, modesty forbids, but if I hadn't been there at the critical moment to jump in after her, she would have perished miserably. Funny thing, too, my father saved my mother from drowning, and I think I know now why he never wanted me to take swimming lessons. It wasn't that I didn't love the girl. I did love her, I admit it. I loved every bone in her head. I loved her because, in the first place, she came of a very aristocratic family, one of her uncles being a retired bank president. The judge retired him for 8 years, and furthermore, she was a very, very pretty girl. She had the most beautiful teeth I ever saw. Oh, really gorgeous, both of them. In fact, she had three, but one was back so far you couldn't see it, so I'm not counting that. Well, anyway, I said to myself, having saved this girl's life, I will propose to her and get married. They do that in the books, and I was out of work anyway, so I picked out a nice evening for the terrible deed, and when I rang the bell, she met me at the door. I had a little bouquet of flowers in my hand, a beautiful bunch of forgive-me-nots, and I got busy immediately. I looked right into her beautiful eyes, and with my voice just choking with emotion and love and buttermilk, I said to her, I said, kitten. I called her kitten till we were married 9 days, and then she got her eyes open. Kitten, I said, will you marry me? She said, yes, I don't care what becomes of me. So I went to her father to get his consent to the marriage, because the marriage of a daughter is always a big event to a father. Sometimes it gets him a home. He was a very nice old gentleman. Anyway, we had been boozing friends. I liked him because he was a well-educated man and a very, very fine musician. Really one of the greatest soup whistlers I ever heard. You ought to hear him whistle a tomato obligato. Well, the morning I called, he was very, very grumpy about something, because when I said to him, politely, I said, Mr. Dingbat, I wish to marry your daughter, and I came to you to get your consent to the union. He said, what will you do if I refuse my consent to this marriage? And I spoke right up with all the bravery of youth. I said, if you refuse your consent, there is only one thing I can and will do. I will simply take your daughter away from you, and you will never lay eyes on her again. So he refused. And I took her over to the parsons immediately. We were united in the holy bunk of matrimony, and you talk about some people profiting by others' mistakes. That minister got $10 out of me for marrying us. Well, after the ceremony, we started off immediately on our honeymoon, and my wife, being a very sensitive woman,